In last decade, we have observed roughly 25% increase in asthma patient in this part of the world. So this is a significant increase in the last decade, which India is observing. And this basically increase especially has been observed in the school-going children. Data shows that roughly 10% of the global burden is shared by India. 300 million cases of asthma globally, and roughly 10% of it, that is 30 million, this is from India. And recently, a published article from India only, that is from Chest Research Foundation, Pune, shows that prevalence of asthma in this country is increasing, and the factors, if you see, the factors are a little bit different from rest of the world. Here, the every third Indian asthmatic is basically asthma is precipitated or triggered by the ice drink. So the cold drink and ice cream in this country, they have been labeled as one of the most important trigger factor, and roughly every third, means 30% of the Indian asthmatics, they are having provocative factor as ice, all ice drink, including cold drink and ice cream. Another study they have shown, especially in Delhi school-going children, where in last decade, the asthma in school-going children has increased from 6% to 16%. So this is because of only two reasons. The fast food growing, you see feeding habits of fast food in children, and increasing obesity. So these are the two important factors which is targeting the Indian childhood population for, and the response, they are responsible for increase, especially in childhood asthma. I think we should give the Indian alternatives for these fast food. Okay. In summer season, usually we take the buttermilk, yeah. Mattha or chach. Yeah. This was the usual drink. And if you go to the southern part of the country, then coconut water is the preferred drink. So I think if we go to the Indian alternative or indigenous alternatives of this fast food, so we can reduce and we can offer to alternative also to the children population, and we can of course our protect the children from development of asthma. So atmosphere pollution, house dust and pollen grains, these are also, and of course smoking and chula smoking in rural females, that is due to chula smoke. So these are the some important responsible factors for in Indian continent. Yes. So I think if you see, the asthma is a genetic disease. Mm. You cannot change the genotype, but you can change the triggers. Okay. For example, regarding the house dust and allergic environment inside the house. Allergic environment inside the house, this is basically because of two reasons. Either house is too dirty, too old, or it is too modern. So both things are the provocative for allergy and asthma disorder. For example, the old house, the dirty house, a lot of you see house dust, and this provokes the asthma patient. This triggers the genotype to convert from genotype asthma to the phenotype of asthma. Genotype means the genetic constitution, phenotype when the symptoms occurs. So house sunlight is also very important, because moisture is also very important trigger factor for asthma. So if you have proper ventilation in the house and proper sunlight in the house, so there is no moisture, there is no fungus formation, so no dirt is there. So that's why you have clean and clean environment. This is one aspect. The second aspect, the two modern houses. Two modern houses, what I mean, that a lot of sofa covers, lot of carpets, lot of curtains in the houses, lot of teddy bears in the houses, because children, they like the teddy bears. So again, the issue of children comes. It has been noticed that the more number of the curtain, more number of sofa covers, more number of teddy bears, they create allergic environment, and more number of the pet animals inside the house. So this creates a modern house of the society. So modernization is also a very important trigger factor for provocating of allergic disorder and asthmatic disorder. So we have to advise that please clean and neat, make the house neat and clean, and don't make it a too modern house. If you want to really have two modern house, then please use vacuum cleaner twice daily. Similarly, the bed sheet of the asthma patient, this should be also changed. You see, Government of India has given a very good order. I really appreciate this order, that now the bed sheet of the patient should be changed every day. And how will they cross check? That they have given the color system of every day. on Monday this color bed sheet, on Tuesday this color bed sheet. So this is a good system. I think everybody, every healthcare system have to change the bed sheet daily. And this is a good system for allergy, asthma disorder also. So that system should be followed in individually also, not only the hospitals, but for all asthmatics, it is my advice that they should change bed sheet every day. Okay. And don't put pet animals inside the house. Okay. One of the important crucial situation is while we are facing the very small children, less than 5 years. This is a really challenge because asthma does not present with the classical symptom of and classical examination of the findings. For example, we have episodic breathlessness as a presentation of asthma. And we, when we put our stethoscope and over the chest of the patient, we find the musical sound. They are called ronchi. But this classical presentation is absent in less than 5 or 6 years population. So that's a usually presentation of cough, nocturnal cough, especially cough in the early morning hours, 4 o'clock, 5 o'clock, child awakens, and usually they started having cough. And they have started, they start having cough while playing, while running. So asthma in this country is, in children, usually it is a underdiagnosis. And usually misdiagnosed as sometimes tuberculosis, yeah. Because asthmatic child is also not growing. Hmm. And when child is not growing, not getting weight, not getting height, usual story in this country is that probably child is suffering from tuberculosis. Okay. So misdiagnosed as tuberculosis. In elderly, it is usually misdiagnosed as COPD. Chronic obstructive pulmonary disease is also very common disease in this country. Usually occurs in smokers. And this is a genetic disease. So usually it is also both presenting with breathlessness. So they are sometimes misdiagnosed as COPD also. Another disease which it is diagnosed is the interstitial lung disease, in which there is a shrinkage of lung. And they also present with dyspnea, usually 40 plus in age. So in middle-aged and elderly people, this is misdiagnosed as interstitial lung disease. And sometimes it is also misdiagnosed as heart disease. So, or even heart disease is misdiagnosed as asthma. And sometimes even anemia in this country, especially in females, if you see, anemia is very common in rural females and a small girl child. So anemia can also be misdiagnosed as asthma, or asthma can be misdiagnosed as anemia. So both way it can happen, because anemia patient also feel breathlessness during walking and during work. So both present with breathlessness complaint, and that's why they can be misdiagnosed by each other. So as far as the asthma treatment is concerned, so proper inhalation therapy with the guidance of asthma specialist is the only answer for asthma patient. Till date, there is no alternative in any therapy. And you see, inhaler, they work only for 12 hours. So action of, duration of action of inhaler is usually 12 hours. So for the preventer inhaler or for the controller inhaler. So you have to repeat the inhaler at every 12 hours. Means twice daily inhalation is the minimum requirement for inhalation therapy. There is no alternative. So that's it advisable that with the help of guidance from the chest physician or asthma specialist, you should take proper inhalation therapy twice daily. And I used to prescribe, I used to advise, like you see, for the last 5-6 years I am wearing the specs. So I ask my patient that it is not the Monday or Sunday on which I put on my specs, but daily I have to be here. So similarly, inhaler has to be taken daily, whether you are well or unwell. It doesn't make any sense. Some people ask that why should I take inhaler regularly? If you don't take inhaler properly, because asthma is a lifelong disease, it's not a disease for years or decades. So what will happen that later on, there is a remodeling of airways so that your bronchial tubes or bronchi, they get forgotten or they forgot to dilate. So what happens later on, even the nebulizers, the inhalers, they don't work. So such situations should not arise, and that's why especially advisable that please take inhaler regularly with the help of, with the guidance of asthma specialist, and so that you should not face the consequences that now your inhaler or nebulizer, even nebulizer, they are not working. So I would suggest the at institute government level, at institution level and society level. The government level, first thing is that certain medicines, they are being provided free of cost by the all hospitals. But most of the hospitals, the inhalers, they are not being provided free of cost. At least for the the BPL card holder or for the lower section of the society, these inhalers should be, the provision should be made that these inhalers should be made free of cost in the government supply. This is one thing. Second thing, there should be regular training program of the doctors, especially posted in rural area or remote areas where they are getting lesser opportunity for being trained. So a special focus should be on training of these doctors practicing or serving in the government level at the PSC level or the CSC level or rural or remote areas. They should be trained properly by asthma specialist regularly, and a certificate should be given that this has been trained in asthma practice. So they should be, this upgradation will lead to the better standard of care, especially in the remote area and rural area. The second thing which we can do at the institution level, that in the medical curriculum, a special lectures, a special demonstration, interactive session should be added to the medical curriculum for the MBBS student, so that, and the practical session should also be involved for the training of asthma management. The third thing which can be done at the society level, and that is the program of awareness. Because if you see the one data, one Indian statistics says that only 20% of Indian asthmatics, they are on inhaler therapy. And very important study, the global study has mentioned that no Indian asthmatic patient is fully controlled, being classified as total control asthma. They have certain criteria, and on the evaluation of these criteria, no Indian asthmatic, not a single patient in this country is fully controlled as far as asthma problem is concerned. So 60%, there's a ratio of 60-40%. The 40% are partly controlled, 60% uncontrolled. And only 20% of Indian asthmatics, they are on inhalation therapy. Rest of the 80%, they are not on inhalation therapy. So a lot of awareness is required at the community level, society level, and we have to involve the political leaders at the block level, Gram Panchayat level. Yesterday our Prime Minister was having a program, beautiful program for strengthening the Gram Panchayat. So we should also strengthen the Gram Panchayat for the health awareness. And this is one of the factors that we should aware the health, local panchayat level, block level people for the asthma. And at the school level, a special drive should be given for school asthma campaign. And the school teachers should be trained how to do when there is asthma attack, what to advise for their asthma patient. During the admission to the school, there should be a screening whether a patient is, whether a child is having asthma or not. A doctor's certificate should be asked. And I still remember 6 years back, 7 years back, when a girl child died in the school due to asthma attack. And this should not happen in this country, because mortality in asthma globally is not a huge problem. Okay. Asthma is a very well-controlled disease if you take inhalation properly. Mortality occurs usually in 1 in 250 asthmatic patients. So it's a very rare thing. It's not a common thing. So we should not face such a consequences which we faced 7 years back, and that is in the capital of the India, that is in Delhi. So that should not be repeated in any school, that a school child due to asthma is dying in the school due to asthma attack. And regular monitoring of asthma patients should be done. So I think these measures, they will, if they are instituted at government level, at institutions level, hospital level, and school level and community level, so they can be very good tools for controlling asthma in this country. Okay.